Insect-sized flying robots could help with time-consuming tasks like surveying crop growth on large farms or snipping out gas leaks. These robots soar by fluttering tiny wings because they are too small to use propellers like those seen on their larger drone cousins. Small size is advantageous. These robots are cheap to make and can easily slip into tight places that are inaccessible to big drones. But current flying robo-insects are still tethered to the ground. The electronics they need to power and control their wings are too heavy for these miniature robots to carry. Now, engineers at the University of Washington have for the first time cut the cord and added a brain, allowing their RoboFly to take its first independent flaps. This might be one small flap for a robot, but it is one giant leap for robot kind. RoboFly is slightly heavier than a toothpick and is powered by a laser beam. It uses a tiny onboard circuit that converts the laser energy into enough electricity to operate its wings. RoboFly is slightly larger than a real fly. Before now, the concept of wireless insect-sized flying robots was science fiction. The engineering challenge is the flapping. Wing flapping is a power-hungry process, and both the power source and the controller that directs the wings are too big and bulky to ride aboard a tiny robot. So the previous robo-insect, the robo-bee, had a leash. It received power and control through wires from the ground. But a flying robot should be able to operate on its own. The research team decided to use a narrow invisible laser beam to power their robot. They pointed the laser beam at a photovoltaic cell which is attached above RoboFly and converts the laser light into electricity. It was the most efficient way to quickly transmit a lot of power to RoboFly without adding much weight. Still, the laser alone does not provide enough voltage to move the wings. That is why the team designed a circuit that boosted the 7 volts coming out of the photovoltaic cell up to 240 volts needed for flight. To give RoboFly control over its own wings, the engineers provided a brain. They added a microcontroller to the same circuit. The microcontroller acts like a real fly's brain, telling wing muscles when to fire. Specifically, the controller sends voltage in waves to mimic the fluttering of a real insect's wings. To make the wings flap forward swiftly, it sends a series of pulses in rapid succession and then slows the pulsing down as you get near the top of the wave. And then it does this in reverse to make the wings flap smoothly in the other direction. For now, RoboFly can only take off and land. Once its photovoltaic cell is out of the direct line of sight of the laser, the robot runs out of power and lands. But the team hopes to soon be able to steer the lasers so that RoboFly can hover and fly around. While RoboFly is currently powered by a laser beam, future versions could use tiny batteries or harvest energy from radio frequency signals. That way, their power source can be modified for specific tasks. Future RoboFlies can also look forward to more advanced brains and sensor systems that help the robots navigate and complete tasks on their own.